You might think that running a business is completely different from doing basic science. However, the two have something in common. Both of them are based on the implementation of ideas. For example, suppose that you are thinking about running a coffee shop. This corner location right next to Kyoto University does not have competitors, and this particular style of the coffee shop with long hours of operation may attract students and may be profitable. If you want to demonstrate that your idea is correct, you really need to do it. That is business. In that sense, research is the same. We come up with research or technology ideas. And to demonstrate that we are right, we really need to do it. That is research. So there are many different driving forces in business and research, but one important driving force in research is to demonstrate that our ideas are actually correct. In this video clip, I will tell you about a scientist who came up with a very nice idea and showed that he was right. That this methodology revolutionized research at the interface between chemistry and biology. Dr. Keith Lam immigrated from Hong Kong to the United States, where he graduated from University of Texas. He obtained a PhD at the University of Wisconsin-Madison and an MD from Stanford Medical School. When Dr. Lam was working at the University of Arizona, he got a super great idea. The methodology, which was published in Nature, was later called the one bead, one compound approach, or split pool synthesis. Let me explain his idea. You learned about the solid phase peptide synthesis in which peptides are bound to large beads. For example, an equal number of beads are placed into three test tubes. These beads in the tube are allowed to react with amino acids A, G, B, respectively. When the reaction is complete, all the beads are placed in a single tube and mixed well. The beads are divided equally into another three tubes. So the tubes should contain all three types of amino acid bound beads, right? Next, the beads in the three tubes are allowed to react with amino acid A, G, V, respectively. Then you will have created 9 different peptides. When the reaction is complete, all the beads are placed in a single tube and mixed well again. The beads are divided equally into another three tubes. Then you get these. You now have three tubes that contain the same 9 peptides. They are allowed to react with A, G, B again, respectively. At this point, 27 different peptides have been generated, as the cube of 3 is 27. So note that each bead is bound to only one kind of peptide. That's why it is called the one bead, one compound method. When these procedures are carried out, 6 rounds for 20 different amino acids, how many different peptides can be generated? That is 20 to the power of 6. 64 million of different peptides. By the one bead, one compound method or split pool synthesis, you can generate x to the power of n compounds where x is the number of monomers and n is the number of steps. In the next video clip, I will show you an example to use a peptide library.